Hey everyone, this is Debbie with Nana's Cooking. Just getting ready to prepare some sausage balls for my family. I'm just wanting to show you a little bit of supplies that I normally use to make these sausage balls. So I already opened up one regular, or this is a hot one here, Jimmy Dean, and then one regular as well. That way it's not too hot for most people. Usually a jar of Cheese Whiz or queso, whichever you prefer. Probably a half a cup of shredded cheese. You can use sharp. I use 2 cups of Bisquick and then I mix. But how I mix is I first mix the two sausages together, get them combined really well. Then I add in my cheese spread, queso, and my cheese. Then slowly I add in the Bisquick and start mixing it till it's well mixed. And then that's where we'll start making balls pretty soon. So I'll show you that here in a second. Okay, so I've already kind of showed you the ingredients that for preparation of making sausage balls. So I'm dumping the first one in my bow. I've already slid it with my scissors. Of course, place in my trash in my famous trash bag. Get ready to slice. This is what I have found that's a lot easier is to just kind of use your scissors if they're clean. Slice it down. Voila. This is the regular. You can use both hot or both regular. And sometimes I have done 2 regulars to 1 hot if you don't like it really hot and spicy. You can even use any brand that you like. I just happen to have Jimmy Dean this time. Yes, it gets messy, so you will be get used to washing your hands every few minutes because it gets in there. All right, so this one is 1 hot, 1 regular. So fun, so fun. As a kid, you probably really would enjoy this. So now I'm going to combine the two together, the 1 mild and 1 hot. So I do this first so it will be a good mixture. At times you've got to get in there with your hands too and just get them messy. That's my oven. I had preheated to 375. So we'll be ready to roll these out here in a little bit. I'm just gonna finish doing all this. All right, so it'll get mixed even better here in a minute. So I kind of make it like a little canyon there so I can put my cheese in it. So sometimes I use, like I said, Cheese Whiz, but we couldn't find any of this trip. So we bought the queso. So we'll just try this one out. It has to be good, right? Can't be wrong, Rohan. Queso is good stuff. So I'm just invented something new. And that's why I always try to tell people, don't be afraid to try different things. And if you like it, hallelujah. If you don't, just don't do it again. So. All right, that's pretty good. Into my trash bag. Oh no, I want this one. Let's try it back out. Okay, this is a little bit bigger. So now I'm going to combine Cheese Whiz in with the, or the queso, I should say, with the sausage and get it good and creamy, cheesy, wonderful stuff. Like I said, man, if you don't like your hands being dirty, don't be doing this one. You could use a mixer too. If you have a good mixer, one of those real big ones, I've seen people do it with the mixer. That works too. I've just always done it with our hands, haven't we, honey?
That's right.
Get in there and get it messy. Makes it fun. And like I said, this is actually my grandkids' favorite sausage balls. She actually asks for them all year round. So when you go make those sausage balls now, yeah, Christmas, New Year's. All right, that's pretty good. Now we're going to add a little bit of cheese. Pinch my fingers off here. Because I got a rinse every once in a while. And you have to re-clean your whole sink because you're messy. Okay. Can use the scissors. Just find it to be a lot easier when you have to open up things. If you want to open, try it again. You want to do a song while I'm doing this, honey?
Yeah. Well, there we go.
Do some entertainment while we have a technical break here. This is I do about half a cup to a cup. It's just, you know, you can even do more. I mean, there's no rules, no laws against that either. So, just a little bit. Okay. I don't use sharp. A lot of people like to use sharp cheese. I'm just not a cheesy person, so I like the mild. And if you don't have shredded cheese, guess what? You don't need it. You don't have to have it because it's Cheese Whiz or queso. It does it for you. It takes care of you. So, this is just a little bit of oomph in it. So, all right. Good news, you don't really even need to season it. I mean, you can season it, but I know some people put garlic powder in it. It's just whatever you prefer, but the sausage already has a pre-seasoned and spices in it. It makes it good. All right, so now we're gonna start adding in a little bit of the Bisquick. And I'm gonna add it slowly, okay? Usually, this is when you start getting your hands in it, start getting mushy. But this is just prepare to do laundry after this. Let me just say, it'll pop out everywhere, especially the chick. It's quick. So, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to take a little break here. I'm going to get this mixed up. And then we'll come right back, and then I'm going to show you how to roast some of them, and then we'll put them in the oven and see what we got. Okay, be right back. Okay, we're back from mixing the Bisquick and starting to do the rolling mechanism here. And just kind of roll it between your hands like that. It doesn't have to be perfect. You know, some people take cookie dippers and dip it in and dump it out. This is whatever sizes you want, small, medium, large. And one little tip I do always use as well is it gets too, a little bit too sticky for you. You can add just a little bit more Bisquick in it to help it from not being that sticky. And then you definitely have to wipe your Bisquick box off a little bit because your hands are all over it. But that helps it. You can just kind of judge it. It's like, yeah, it's a little sticky. Let's just add a little bit more Bisquick in there. You can't take away, but you can always add. So I've always been told that. So just like cutting your hair, you can always cut more, but you can't bring it back. All right, about an inch or so apart so they can expand. This is the fun part you want to do for your kids. They like to get in their hands messy. Have you some relaxing music on, just kind of, you can sit down at the table and do this if your back starts hurting, which I've been known to do, let me tell you. And we're going to bake these here in a second and get to see, and you kind of judge, I'm doing a small pan first, just kind of judge how big I want them, or make it look like this one looks a little bit big, but I'll just take it away from that one a little bit. That'd be a jammy one, right?
Yes, that's mine.
Yeah. You can see that shredded cheese sticking out. I don't know if you can see that or not. Some of the shredded cheese. It's just making it all goody. Okay. And one other thing that I do too after I make a pan just to make sure I like them, I roll them again on a couple other pizza pans. Put them in my freezer for about 15 minutes or 20 minutes. Take them back out, and you could put them in freezer bags label them, and then you can get them out the morning of Christmas or Christmas Eve, New Year's Eve. You already got them pre-made for breakfast or for your snack. Like I have like three parties, I'm bringing sausage balls. So I'll put them in the freezer after I get done making a few here, then I'm gonna put them in the freezer as well. So I'm gonna put these in the oven with my dirty hands. So let's go over here for a second. Yes, we're gonna be cleaning the stove, honey, in the oven.
All right.
Okay. Let's do about, I think 12 to 15 minutes. So let's start that, hit the timer. Let's do 12 first. Let's just look at them. And then what I do, if they look dead on the bottom, I turn the boiler on because I like mine a little crunchy on the top. So stand guard because I put the boiler on for like a minute or so and I'm standing there ready to grab them. So when they get really crunchy on top is when I pull them out. So we're going to take a little break again. We're going to bake these and then we'll come back. Okay, so we have put these in the oven. At first I said 12 minutes. I moved it up to 14 minutes because they're a little bit bigger than I normally make. So now I just kicked it over to boiler on high for about a minute or so, and I'm just kind of watching it to see. Make it a little bit browner on top. I like them a little crunchy and brown on top. That looks delicious already. It smells so good. You can smell it. And I'm starting to see some browning on the top. Looking good. So like I said, you got to babysit it when you're doing the broiler. Don't turn your back on it because they will be burnt within seconds. Alrighty. That's looking good now, I think. I think that's good. So let me hit cancel. And then I'm going to attempt to get them out. Yum. Bring them over here and I'm gonna let them cool for a little bit and then we will enjoy them and have a little bit of taste test. But like I said, I made them a little bit bigger this time than normal, but that's okay. It's so good, you don't mind it at all. So I already put some in the freezer for the next 15, 20 minutes and I'll get those back out. And then I'm gonna put them in my Ziploc baggies, my freezer bags, to have them for future use. So hope you enjoy this recipe. I know my family does, my kids do. I know this is one of the future recipes I want to leave my kids because it's always been their favorite. So I pray you all have a blessed day, a blessed holiday, and Merry Christmas.
Hey, Nana, tell them to like and subscribe.
Where's Rosie when I need her?
Right.
See, I forgot already. Thank you, honey. Yeah, hit like and subscribe. Sorry.